Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to show you guys my jewelry collection, but I do have quite a lot and I think it's gonna take a really long time to explain and show you each one. So I'm going to show you, you know, kind of overview and talk through each brand and what I think of them. And I will narrow down to my favorite ones and most worn and wear and tear I can also talk about. I'm wearing so many necklaces here is because I wanted to show you guys up close and also talk about it. And also I have one earring right here because just got lazy to put another one on, but also didn't want to forget to talk about, as this is the custom jewelry. And let me just say about custom jewelries from luxury brand like Chanel ones, double CC crystal earrings in silver, and these are the smallest, and I have the one in gold crystal again, but it's the bigger CC. So these cost around $600 or $650 now, I'm not sure, but the price always go up. Crystals are very very blingy and beautiful. I love these as well. I was really into getting Chanel earrings and necklaces, and also I have the bracelet here with their beautiful pearl. I love this, is the matching set. So things like these, I love them. These are custom jewelry, which means not 14 karat gold or 24, no gold, you know, and the pearls are not real, but they are made so well and high quality, of course, so they could price it, you know, really, really expensive for what they are. Do I recommend them? I do. If you want one or two pairs, I think it's a great addition to have, and they look so pretty. And Dior, I love their earrings as well, and I have this, their tribal classic earrings, rose gold with the silver on the front. This is the original one with their pearl. Okay, this is the ABC charm, and this each piece cost, like I said, $600. Simply, just let me say, if you have two or three custom jewelries from luxury brands, I say slow down. You don't have to go too fast. You don't have to have so many. Eventually, when you get older, you're gonna want more of real, like fine jewelry or real diamond, or yeah, anyways, something real that you can have for longer time, and also they are more valuable than these custom, even though Chanel jewelries do value pretty well for their, you know, resale market. But still, I don't really think it's smart to buy so many. That's my suggestion. So after Chanel, I went nuts about Hermes bracelets. So I went with each color that I really 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 loved, and I still wear these time to time, and I love the look of them. So for wear and tear, these I've had for many years. They don't tarnish, or they don't get rusty, or they don't really change the color of them. So amazing quality. I do recommend Hermes Click Clack. This is the beautiful Lagoon, nice pop, and also it is pretty heavy. I wouldn't say really heavy, but it's got the weight to it. It's not cheap or cheaply made. So only rose gold I have is this one with that pink, baby pink color. This is my favorite just because I love pink, And also rose gold, it just blends in into my skin color, so it does not scream, like, you know, it's not too much in your face. So I love this, and I like sticking with my love here, love bracelet. I forgot to talk about wear and tear on Chanel jewelries. They stay quite well, better than I expected. Crystals, none of them have fallen off at all, especially when you have the one looking like this instead of crystal, like when there is pearl. A lot of people complain about that, but so far I've had these for a really long time, but they stay still the same, so the quality is great. And wear and tear, I don't really experience bad. And also Dior, great quality. Their pearls are the prettiest, beautiful ivory shade. I just love Dior. I can't pronounce it. Anyways, with the short version, they call it CDC. Popular color combination, sell out pretty fast, but I'll have the link to the same one if I can find them. This one is with the croc band in pink with that palladium hardware. I love this so much because the pink, and also I love their palladium hardware. And if you're wondering about the size, for me, I go with the size small. I could go with extra small, but having a little bit of room is better. That's what my essay recommended. And their new sizing is T2 is the size small. So T1 will be extra small. Of course, these are the statement jewelry. So when you wear this, you don't have to have earrings or anything, but it just speaks just by itself. It just makes your whole outfit look so chic and very fashionable, but also there's like luxe touch to it. So I absolutely love pairing it with simple outfit. And let me just take this off and switch to non-luxury brand, but it is super luxurious in quality, and I love Ana Luisa. This is their hoop earring, size medium. They call it Mia. And I find they're just so simple and elegant and beautiful to wear, casual and dressy. Just perfect size, medium. Large look really chic as well, but for me, I don't know, for my taste, I like more of dainty ones, like what I'm wearing right here that I need to talk about also. And another brand that I also really love is Georgina. I buy them from Nordstrom. The coin necklace have been around for some time and very trendy, and now it's everywhere, of course, but this is my favorite and most worn. Definitely, I believe you guys have seen me wearing this a lot on my channel. I love it. The detail is really beautiful, and love wearing it. Even on this top, looks really nice also. And the price is really good as well. And now, let me tell you the details about what I am wearing right now and I wear all the time. One that I've had maybe for 10 years. I am not sure how long I've had, but this is the one from Tiffany & Co. And my husband bought it for me for my birthday, or I don't remember honestly if it was anniversary, but birthday. Anyways, it is from my dear husband, and they have different size stone, the diamond you can choose, but this particular one is 0.07, so it's so tiny. But I love about that how tiny and just dainty and delicate look to it, and it layers so well with any necklace. I'll have the collection name right here. I can't think of it right now, but it's L something, and it is from Tiffany. They originated, but it's everywhere pretty much. So I do recommend, if you're a big fan or you want the title Tiffany & Co., but I'll say you can go with other brand that have really similar, seriously, same look, super dupe. I'll have the link down below. I know one from Ana Luisa. They have the lab-grown diamond just like this with just all like really little money compared to this. This at that time, I even remember how much it cost. $1,250, so it is with the yellow gold chain, but the chain is super tiny, so it's not like a lot of material, but cost a lot because of the name brand. So you can go with other brand, and also if you go to your local jewelry store, you can ask them to make it just like this and they will do it for you with little money. This is my number one favorite of mine and most worn, longest time that I've had, and I didn't lose. I'm so glad I didn't, because I used to lose a lot of jewelry. So my husband was like, I'm not gonna buy you anything anymore, but you know, I used to swim, but that's where I lose a lot and I should not be wearing those. But anyways, I'm rambling here. So that is my number one, and these three are from Van Cleef & Arpels, and I love, like I talked about, I love dainty small necklaces, and I wear necklace all the time, at least one, but two. This I get asked the most. Let me get close to it. The name of it is Alhambra Butterfly Necklace, pendant necklace, and it is with the mother of pearl. As you can see on the front, and when you flip it, it's the same. It's with the yellow gold. It's just so beautiful, and I love butterfly in general. And someone who is so dear to me, who passed away not long ago, she loved butterflies, so that, you know, affected me to love butterflies so much also. Anyways, I really love and miss her. When I see this, when I wear this, I think of her also, even though my husband bought it for me. Anyways, I love it. And I do highly recommend this if you love dainty size pendant necklace. It's like lean next to it, so it looks like flying. And if you see some scar here or the scratch areas, those are from my little boy, Caleb. He just tends to do that. And so Van Cleef, if you go to their website, you will see different name out of Alhambra collection. This is the smallest, so it's the cutest. They call it sweet, so it's tiny, different shape you can also find, and that butterfly also is the sweet, so cute. And it stands out just tiny bit, you know, like little. I find this so cute and lovely. And this is with the stone, Carmen. It's the red stone, and the color changes depending on the lighting. This is the one, Alhambra Vintage, which is one size bigger than the sweet. And there is another one called Magic, which is a lot bigger than this one. This is the one, I think they call it Guilong. It is faceted every angle. It's got like tiny like technology, the way how they cut it. I went to the store to get vintage Alhambra, the mother of pearl. But when I saw this, I fell in love crazy, because it looked like having diamond with the yellow gold, just so shiny when it moves. Anyways, I love it. And it is the set with, oops, this one, this bracelet. So the size is same motif as this one. These were the limited edition when they were available. They have the silver one now, like white gold. I am so tempted to go for them because I love these so much. The reason that I went with this over mother of pearl is that mother of pearl, even though they are pearl, cut certain way, and you know, they went processed, so if you wear them in the shower, they're gonna be ruined eventually. So I wanted to wear these just all the time, like I do with the love bracelets here. So I went with the gold, and I wear them all the time, but they look fantastic, still looking gorgeous. and I don't see any scratches or any of the marks, but I still want to get my little pearl version with the yellow gold. Love bracelet, yellow gold, it's the original thickness. So this I got first. It's been about 5 years now, and as you can see all the scratches, I still adore it. So that's the first one I got. After loving this so much, I wanted to stack next to it, so I went with this white gold, and this is the newer size. Some of you ask me and DM me quite often, ask which one I recommend. I recommend the thinner one just because the way it opens and it hangs, and it's just more comfortable and it's thinner, so it's not as heavy. So if you're gonna get one, maybe get the original just by itself. I just wish I had the yellow gold with the diamond first and have the same thin one like this, same one, white gold. But still, I love this one, and I went with the size 17, which is quite big. And recently I added this gorgeous Justin Claw, and this one is with the yellow gold and have the diamonds on the nail section and on this pointy area, so it dresses up quite a lot and you can take it off quite easy. You just push up and it opens up. So, and it is not as comfortable as love bracelet because it sticks out, and when you wear like lace thing, which I love wearing, like lace top, this does get into the hook. So I just have to be careful, but I'm so grateful to have these. And these became a lot heavier, I'm not gonna lie, from adding this. And the Rolex watch right here, I love, and it is my favorite watch from my watch collection because I love mother of pearl, and also I love this classic style. They just love the chain that is super elegant and classy, and it's so smooth, and because it's got many small sections, it holds my wrist better, I'll say, than this one. This is more chic version, and this is the white gold with the stainless steel mixed together and white face, which makes it super chic and fresh. And this is my favorite to wear during the summer, and spring and summer I love wearing this.
Mama, look.
What is it?
I built this by myself.
You did?
Yeah.
Oh wow, I love it. Super cool.
Mommy, I have something too. Look. Way cool.
So nice.
And you good can job. And you can choose different of these. Oh. It's a race car.
Yeah. Woo. Thank you for showing Mommy and there's everyone. Lydia got this gift from her uncle. It's got the 10 diamond, so it does dress up but also casual enough, as it doesn't have diamond even all around right here, which is beautiful. And I wish to get one in the future, but not from Rolex, but I'm thinking of going with this new brand that I'm not quite familiar with, but I've been really obsessed, and I'll have the picture right here. I can't not pronounce, sorry guys, but I love it. I've been wanting to get the old rose gold with the diamond, so in the future I would love to get it. These are from Cartier, and this is the first luxury watch I ever got, and it's just beautiful, super classy. And this, I'm not sure if they still have this 10th collection, but I adore it. Love, love, love. This is a large size that they had, and I do wear this quite often with casual outfit, more so. This is Cartier Bleu de Blue. I absolutely adore that pink mother of pearl shade on the face, and also the mix rose gold and the stainless steel. It's feminine, which I love, and also classy from Cartier. And it's very comfortable to wear. And these are two Chanel J12 watches. I have one in white And this one is in black, ceramic, so super durable, super like water resistant, scratch resistant. These will last forever and ever, so I love, and I love the look of them, and very classy from Chanel. But these are more of fashion jewelry, I'll say. Like, if you are looking to invest in luxury brand watches, I'll say more of Rolex or Cartier from my collection. There's a lot more brands. These I recommend to those who love Chanel and who want to have, you know, not just handbag or jacket from Chanel. This one is the limited edition one, so they don't have this anymore, but it's got like moon face, and it's got the diamond inside as well as just everywhere. So it is more blingy and dressy, but because it's with the black, it also looks great with the casual outfit as well. And this is the white one with the pinky mother of pearl face. And all of my watches are automatic, so I do need really good watch winder, but I don't have one. The one that I had broke. If you know, and if you have any recommendation, let me know. It was a gift from my husband. He got this beautiful 2-carat diamond as a gift, and we made it to the necklace, but this broke. And I get asked about my wedding ring and engagement ring. It's from Helzberg. My husband and I thought of upgrading with the size of the diamond. This is like smaller than 1 carat in the middle of it, and it's brilliant cut, so it's blingy and beautiful. I still love it. Time to time, we're like going back and forth. We like to just stick with this because we want to remind ourselves those days when we had nothing and lived in an apartment, you know, when we just got married, or right before we got married when he gave me this. I thought it's the most, you know, beautiful thing in the world. I still think that it is gorgeous. I love it. And you guys still asked me, it is from Helzberg, but I don't think they have the same one anymore. But they do make Brilliant Cut, and I do recommend Brilliant Cut as just really like shiny and sparkly. And this was the colorless. Great memory we have. Here is the love ring. I think I got this first before I even got the love bracelet, yellow one. So it is very first love line to my life. I loved it so, so, so much. I got one for my husband as well, so we both have the same one, the original size, and this has no diamond. And this is the white gold love ring with the tiny one single diamond here, the thinner one. I tried the same size as the original one to stick together, but it was hard to bend, so this was just perfect, and I can still bend and stick two together just like what I have right here. So, and I cannot skip this, right? Because I wear these so much, and these are another favorite of mine from Lindy's. I love her back charms, but also I love her bracelets. I love that camellia flower shape bracelet. I still have promo code for you to use 15% off. LV Lover CC 15 off. It's so girly on the bottom. It moves. And now actually she has the pearl one, of course, I ordered, and it's coming, so I can't wait to try it on. But it has the pearl white and also pink one and mixed together, and obviously the signature heart charm is dangly, so it's gonna be very, very feminine and girly and pretty. And last but not least, let me show you Tiffany & Co. jewelries that I used to wear a lot and love. They have changed the color to more of like dark gray color. I still have everything that you guys used to see me wearing. I just haven't had a chance to clean them up. And this is the cloth that you can buff it off. It just takes time for you to rub it and it becomes more of lighter shade silver. Anyways, I just wanted to mention that I still have them because sometimes you guys ask me, do you still love Tiffany & Co? And do you still have them? And I'm like, yes, I do, but I just forget to buff this off because that's the only thing about it. You have to go through this process to make it more shiny and prettier. And look, it already changed. I still have the earrings and everything, so it's like cuff. You can stack also. Forgot about this. Oh, and this is another recent favorite of mine, and I do wear these so much. Hoop earrings, very interesting shape. These are from Nordstrom as well, and the brand Kendra Scott, and gorgeous quality as well. I think I mixed so many, so I don't think you can really tell what's my most worn, but the ones that I'm wearing actually are my most worn and also, yeah, my favorite ones. So I hope you guys enjoy watching this video. Let me know in the comment below what's your favorite jewelry that you're wearing right now and you wear the most. And let all of us know what's your favorite. And if you haven't entered my giveaway that is going on, I will link to it down below for you to check it out. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys!